do you say goodbye to an airline? An airline that has a special place in the history books. An airline that for 61 years has survived under the same name, longer than any other.
And how do you say goodbye to an airline that for many of us has represented much more than a paycheck? It's been a lifestyle, our friends, like family for some.
Before we become another company, before we transfer, or some of us go our separate ways, we thought it was time to take a look back, some of the early years, some of the recent years, some of the people and the places that have made our airline special. I'm Ken McConnell.
And I'm Leslie Kumamoto. And we're Western.
Like the pine trees lining the winding road, I've got a name, I've got a name. Like the singing bird and the croaking toad, I've got a name, I've got a name. And I carry it with me like my daddy did, but I'm living the dream that he kept here. Moving me down the highway, rolling me down the highway, moving the hills till I won't pass me by.
What was your first airplane?
Douglas M2, the first airplane Western Air had. It took you 7 hours to fly from L.A. to Salt Lake. There were no altitudes specified at that time. You could go up or down as you saw fit in those early days, which was a big help.
Passengers in those days, what did they say after they got off the flight?
Well, many of them were pretty frightened, and it was hard to get them to talk to you. But they're, within a couple, 3 years or so after I started flying, there were those who flew quite regularly, and they enjoyed the flight as well. And they told you that they did, and so on. At that time, we would allow them to come up in front like in the tri-motor and try their hand at flying the airplane. There was no regulation against it, and of course you'd stay in your seat and watch them. And they thought that was pretty nice to be able to do that.
Back in 1926, a group of prominent Los Angeles business leaders decided that the West should have its own airline. An airline that would meet the business needs of the West. So armed with enthusiasm and a few adventurous pilots, America's first commercial airline took flight, carrying mail between Los Angeles and Salt Lake City.
People couldn't believe that you were trying to sell them to travel by air, because they'd only do it in an extreme emergency. But we realized, actually, that if we could just get a person to fly our airplane and that they could save time, that they could benefit their industry or benefit whoever they represented. And then, of course, we did a lot of business with the studios. One of our best customers originally was the department stores, all the buyers.
Western Airlines understands the pace of modern business travel.
Rodney, Monday flight to Seattle, Tuesday L.A., Wednesday D.C., Thursday Boise, and Friday Chicago. Quimby, Monday Salt Lake, Tuesday New York, Wednesday Honolulu, and Saturday Anchorage!
You don't have to race for seats with Western Airlines advanced pre-reserved seating.
I didn't know!
You shouldn't spend your life flying to earn a frequent flyer reward, so Western Airlines gives you one after just 5,000 miles.
Western Airlines, count on us!
They've had something, an intangible spirit of service that has been unique in the airline industry. The innovations they put in, the gut feeling for the passenger that Western's always had, it just always made me feel sentimental about the airline. They introduced the first flight attendants. Most people credit United because they hired the first stewardesses, but they weren't the first flight attendants. Western hired them in the years when they started the old pig and whistle sandwiches on the model airway between L.A. and San Francisco. That was a first. Up till then, you know, a box lunch was a luxury dinner. The Hunt breakfasts. I have heard airline culinary experts airline food service people say that that is the best single meal ever introduced in the entire industry.
From the moment you are greeted by a smiling stewardess, attractive in her evergreen uniform, and you step inside these big modern airliners, your pleasure is Western's responsibility. Your plane, one of Western's great DC-6B Pacific Coast fleets. There's power to spare in those mighty engines, and you settle back in king-size seats to enjoy the comforts of air travel, as through the unusually large panoramic windows, you follow your flight over the most scenic areas in all the West. Certainly, this is travel in the modern manner.
In the winter, I the ball.
This is one of the best groups I've ever worked with. In fact, one of the best jobs I ever had.
I identified with Western. It was part of the West. It was a part of me.
My years at Western have been exciting, diverse. I've met quite a few different people. I've been paid well. I feel I've been treated good.
I think a swell group of people to work with overall throughout the years.
On the whole, it's been a family atmosphere all the way along, and it still is.
I think it's quite the company. And they always have been. There's a lot of pride. People have worked hard to make this airline go, and you can see where they've taken the pay cut. They were willing to do that just to make sure the airline survived.
This is an extraordinary group of people. A lot of other companies have been faced with the same kind of challenge and haven't done quite so well with it. It's not just what was done, it's the way it was done. It was done with dignity and with pride and with an awful lot of guts. There were a lot of people who did not like day in and day out going and flying on those planes and knowing that their futures were uncertain and that the company might not last and that they were being asked to be courteous and charming and graceful and cooperative and attentive when the very rock and foundation of their life was in jeopardy. And that's a tough thing to do, and some companies were not able to do it, and this one did.
Call up Western Airlines, we're nearby. We will quote the hours you can fly.
On your carefree journey through the sky.
Fly with Western Airlines, fly with Western Airlines, fly with Western Airlines.
Reaper.
depressing. Western Airlines, the only way to fly.
Just how far does your frequent flyer program expect you to go? To get 6 upgrades and a free trip on United, it's 110,000 miles. On American, it's 122,000, halfway to the moon. But Western Airlines Travel Pass 2 gives you 6 first-class upgrades and a free trip to places like Hawaii or Mexico in just 40,000 miles. So if you're not flying Western, you've got to be a real space cadet.
Hi, Aunt Agatha. How was your flight on Western?
Just perfect. Darn it.
Western pays the buck of love. Western pays the buck.
They're all cut Western Airlines. Mike Anders breaking on the inside, suitcase on the outside, and challenges for the lead. Anders saving ground on the escalator. Suitcase now making its move. Anders holding on gamely. As they come into the stretch, it's suitcase and Anders neck and neck. Coming to the wire, it's suitcase and Anders, Anders and suitcase. It's going to be close.
10-minute luggage delivery. At Western, we're trying to get first bags to the claim area within 10 minutes of arrival. When you go Western, you go fast class.
Better luck next time, kid.
And welcome to the 60th anniversary of Western Airlines.
One, a pioneer in service. Two, one of the gutsiest, most courageous airlines that ever existed. An extremely tough competitor because of its size. Western had a reputation for integrity. When you kill off an airline through merger or bankruptcy or what have you, all you got left is history and tradition. And if you forget that, the airline's gone. Keep the memories. Keep their tradition alive.